So I, last night watching this film, I've just taken by it. It's something that stayed with me. I love this story. And for you, I think there must be an inherent challenge portraying someone who was not only who has lived as a real life person, but was a hero. Mm. So what was your process of getting to know and understanding Desmond Doss?
It was a privilege. It was like being given the greatest book report of all time. You know, you get to go and study a figure, a historical figure that no one really knows about, because he himself wanted to remain hidden and humble in a very sincere way. Like, he wasn't setting out to be a hero in any way, shape, or form. He was just setting out to be who he was, and it resulted in these heroic deeds. There's some incredible alchemy in that process that he went through. And of course, in alchemy, you need a lot of heat, you need a lot of fire, and there was the heat of battle and the fire of battle, the hell of battle that created the diamond that Desmond was born to be. So for me, it was just, you know, reading all the books and seeing the documentary. And there's a great documentary that Terry Benedict made about Desmond, very comprehensive. And it's just kind of absorbing the spirit of the man. And you never think you can absorb enough. So, yeah.
Well, I know you're no stranger to creating war movies, but I have to say, watching this film, I feel like I've never seen war like this before. And I loved it and I hated it all at the same time. It was so powerful, so intense. So what was important to you to bring out about the war? What was your visual goal?
Well, visually, I wanted to give the audience a feeling of what it must have been like to be in the midst of something like that. And it would have been brutal. Maybe I didn't make it as brutal as it was. I don't know, but I imagine that it looked like that. And from research, of course, you know, it's the first time they used a lot of napalm, and you know, and there was a steel rain of bullets. The Japanese called it a rain of steel, and all the explosions. I mean, so doing that was kind of technical, but it's the way of looking at it that's kind of more important. And I had a very good camera team, and a lot of people helped me achieve the look and the feel of that in the edit and stuff like that. So.
When it comes to just the man, Desmond Doss, and just thinking about what he did, he went in on the front line without a gun. He was a man who survived, but he also saved. So just taking that under consideration, would you say that this is a film about faith and maybe even miracles?
Yeah, I think those are two pretty good words. Yeah,
absolutely.
And surround and hang out with Desmond, or seem to hang out with Desmond on top of that ridge. You know, 75 men. The size of Mel, or sometimes bigger, and Desmond was my size. He was probably a little bit stronger than me, but you know, we were about the same build. And it's a physical impossibility to do the things that he did, you know. So I believe that there was divine assistance. There was divine help. There was some angelic force. Call it what you will. You know, insert your belief system here. And that's the thing that I think. Another thing that Desmond transcended was his own specific path was Christianity and being a Seventh-day Adventist. But his actions transcend even that particular set of rules. It was a deeper thing somehow.
Yeah, God is love, you know, and he believed in something greater than himself, and he was willing to sacrifice his own life for his brothers. And this is the greatest act of love anyone can do. So in the midst of hell, where most men are becoming animals, he was honing this aspect of himself and doing glorious things and saving lives. He was life-affirming in the midst of death. You know, it's kind of a cool story.
Made in Hollywood. Thanks for watching this interview. As always, don't forget to subscribe and let us know what you think in the comment section below. For the next Made in Hollywood interview, click right here. Do it. Click it.